Why, hello, this is Mike Mu here from Mike Mu Online, Mike Mu Gadget Review, and thank you for watching my YouTube video. This is about how to fast charge your iPhone 10 or iPhone 8 or iPhone 8 Plus, anyone that supports the fast charging that Apple has advertised as being able to be charged in 50 to 50% battery life in roughly 30 minutes. Now, what they advertise here is actually best case scenario in the lab, ideal conditions. We're talking about using their $25 USB-C to Lightning power cable, along with a comparable third-party USB-C power adapter that supports something called USB-PD, which stands for power delivery. And there are many different options available. I'm using one of the most powerful ones that Apple has available, actually the most powerful one that Apple has available at this time. This is the one that comes with the MacBook Pro Retina with the touch bar that is USB-C powered. And I got this separately since I don't have a MacBook, I don't have one of the new MacBooks. This will put up to, it's rated at 87 watts. And I wanted to see just if this is going to make a difference in terms of how fast you can charge. Ideally, you should just get the 29 watt USB Type-C power adapter, which is quite a bit cheaper and quite a lot lighter. I have the same one available because I use that on my regular MacBook, which is the MacBook 12, so I don't have to pay extra for that type of adapter. Now, you'll notice down at the bottom, I actually have a USB-C watt meter. This is by Satechi. I backed this on Kickstarter, so let you know roughly what we're looking at here in terms of the voltage and amperage that is going in live. And I should also mention in this example, obviously I have the screen going on, and I have basically all the surfaces going on, so it is taking more power, and so this would not be ideal lab conditions, obviously. And I also actually was messing around with the screen recording function. So it was actually actively recording the screen as this was being charged right now. So that does affect roughly how much you're going to get. So in ideal lab conditions, of course, you're going to have the screen off, you're going to have an airplane mode, you're going to turn off all the other stuff, put it in low power mode, and start to charge. And you'll probably reach pretty darn close to 50%, if not 50% within the half hour that Apple advertises. One thing I should mention down here at the bottom, you'll see that it is at a voltage of 8.9 or roughly 9 volts, and the amperage is over there on the right-hand side at 1.2 all the way up to 2, and that is because this 87 watt adapter actually has different power delivery modes. So if you look on the bottom of an 87 watt adapter, you'll see that it supports 20.2 volts at 4.3 amps. This is what you're going to be using when you're charging a MacBook Retina 15, right? And then it has a 9 volt 3 amps, which is basically what we're getting the mode and the voltage that is charging right now. And then it has a 5.2 volt at 2.4 amps setting, and that would probably be for charging, probably once it's starting to trickle down, you'll see near the end of the video whether or not changes the voltages, just to see what's more optimal for it to charge. Now, if you're using the 29 watt version, that one actually supports output of 14.5 volts at 2 amps or 5.2 volts at 2.4 amps. And I tried this test both with the 29 watt one and 87 watt one. And the 29 watt one would actually output at the roughly 14.5 volts at point some odd amps. Okay, so it'll the amount of voltage that actually comes out it will vary depending on what kind of PD system you have. And when you're looking at these fast charging adapters, I'm going to go ahead and say this. If you have an iPhone 10, I'd recommend getting, I mean, don't get a cheap non-brand one. You want to get something good. You want to get something legit, one of the big name brands out there, right? And if you want to be really safe, just stick with the Apple ones. I'm sure you're going to pay the extra Apple tax, but at least you know that you're using a legit power adapter. that isn't going to cause damage to your iPhone any more than, you know, what's been expected and tested, because that's exactly what Apple uses. And it's actually all manufactured by Delta Electronics, anyhow, in China. But, you know, do you really want to risk your iPhone 10 being an over $1,000 iPhone on a cheap adapter that you might find on eBay that is lying about its stats, unless you're able to test it like an engineer, like that one Google engineer that was testing all the USB-C cables and chargers and letting you know that there are actually some being sold on Amazon that are actually really dangerous for your phone. So do yourself a favor. Probably stick with the big name brands, you know, like Anker and you know, Delta, which manufactures all of the Apple power adapters that we've been using for years. Here's another thing you should note. Right now we're getting close to around the 70% battery level. You will see that as we get closer and closer to full capacity, the amount of power being charged into it actually decreases. So that is to help protect and prolong the battery life and protect the device. So that's why you'll see things where it says, well, you can get up to 50% charge level on your iPhone in 30 minutes. But if that's the case, if you're going at the same rate, shouldn't you be able to get a full-on iPhone charge within 1 hour? Well, no, because that is designed mostly as a safety feature, and you know, you definitely can't do that because you're going to get a lot of heat out of the device, and we want to keep, you know, Apple, you know, Samsung, you know, all these major manufacturers are want to be really careful about how they handle the batteries in here, because they can be quite dangerous, as we've seen on news and explosions when batteries aren't handled properly or designed properly or charged properly. Yeah, so I can't stress that enough. So now we're getting around 80%. This is where the charging rate really slows down quite a bit from here on out. So you can see we're at, 1 hour and 18 minutes into the charging. And this is really going to slow down quite a bit. So this last 20% is going to take the last 40, 50 minutes of charging at this rate. If you want to find out roughly how many watts is going in, you just multiply the volts multiplied by the amps, and you'll know right away, you know, what the live charge is going in there. And that will, you know, that'll jump around a bit because, you know, this is it's a safety feature that communicates between both the phone and the adapter through the charger. I want to spend a couple of minutes talking about fast wireless charging, sorry. Right now, just a couple of days ago, the fastest you could charge was at 5 watts, which is basically just the same exact speed as you would get just plugged in with the, you know, the included charger on all iPhones, which is the same old 5-watt charger since the beginning of iPhone, since iPhone 1. All right, so that's 5 watts. Recently, a couple of days ago, they had a firmware update to 11.2, which allows you to do fast wireless charging, which now increases it from 5 watts to 7.5 watts of maximum power coming out. So that's a 50% increase. Now, that might sound like a lot, but 50%, realistically, you're just going from 5 watts. You're just adding an extra 2.5 watts potential when you're doing the fast charging, which is basically from 0 to 50% or 60-70%, all right? And what that really translates out to is that within 1 hour, you get 7% more battery charge. That's it, 7% more. So if you're on the market for a Qi wireless charger, you find one that you like, and then you find out that, you know, the fast charge version is going to cost you an extra $20-$30, just get the regular one. That unless you really need that 7%. And if you did really need that 7%, you should rather spend your money on one of these USB-C PD chargers, either from Apple or Anker or one of the other big name brands that that makes USB PD adapter devices. So yeah, fast charging isn't all that. I've been using wireless charging for a really long time, provided by several other companies. And the reason why they don't go above 7.5 watts right now is because Apple has not figured out how to do it safely and without generating that much heat that would then damage the battery and the amount of battery life you'd get. So I will say I've seen this firsthand using Qi wireless chargers and external battery packs and charging. Sometimes the heat gets up to the point where, you know, I feel a little bit uncomfortable, meaning that I know that at this temperature with all the electronics all inside and in the heat and using in a car and, you know, in a windshield, that is damaging the battery. And you're just going to use up way more battery than, I mean, your battery life is just not going to be as great as versus someone who isn't using wireless charging. So wireless charging should really be used for convenience. Not really great for topping up. It's good for maintaining the battery life. If you have it in various areas, you know, you can set it down. If you're only going to be putting down for a little bit, it'll just at least maintain a charge, give you 1 or 2% in the meantime between, or just for convenience sake. And I find that that is really convenient. Or if you're doing overnight charging, that's fine because you're going to be charging, you know, pretty slow. And at the 5 watt mark, you're really looking at 3.5 hours to charge, which is the exact same thing as if you plug the in with a 5 watt adapter. So you're fine with that. But if you're always on the go, and you're going from meeting to meeting, to office, to the car, etc., having a USB PD power system is going to help, especially if you have the GPS going on, you have everything turned on, you're streaming Wi-Fi, hotspot, all that stuff. Getting more power into your phone is going to make life better, particularly if you have a smaller phone. And if you're a power user, and I identify myself as a power user because I really put a lot into the phone. This iPhone 10 is not going to make it throughout the whole day for me, not the way I use it, which is unfortunate. So I'm going to have to look through external battery packs or maybe wait until next year when they have the iPhone 10 Plus or 10S Plus, whatever they're going to call it. All right. So total amount of time charge was just over 2 hours, 2 hours and 6-7 minutes using the 87 watt adapter, which comes out to be roughly the same as what everybody else seems to get on the 29 watt USB type C power adapter. So you do get some benefits from using the 87 watt, but not enough to justify the price difference or the weight savings, because the 87 watt adapter actually charges a lot faster at the very beginning than the 29 watt one, but only for a short period of time. Yeah, I've noticed that. So if you're constantly running on low, 87 watt might make sense, but I'd say just stick with the 29 watt one, 29 watt Apple USB Type-C power adapter. All right, I hope this video is useful to you, and I'll have links down below. Maybe in a video, you can just scan a QR code about getting these. These are just actual Apple USB Type-C power adapters that are designed for their own MacBooks, for Apple's own MacBooks, so that shouldn't be too hard to find. All right, thanks for watching. Please click like and subscribe. If you like it, subscribe for more videos. And if you didn't like it, please at least let me know why. I try to be helpful in most of my videos, and it does take some time, even though I don't do as much crazy editing as a lot of other YouTubers. It's because if I did that, sometimes I wouldn't ever get the video out. All right, thanks for watching. I'll catch you in the next video. The results of my testing are as follows. For the iPhone 10 running iOS 11.1.2, which is the latest as of today, November 19, 2017, you will benefit from USB-C PD power delivery fast charging that will be fastest all the way up to about 73%. Once you hit the 73% mark, an iPad charger will do just as fast as a USB-C fast charging solution, all the way up to 100%. And then once you hit 76%, your wireless fast charging solution, any of the $50 price point or Mophie wireless Qi chargers, will charge just as fast as the USB-C PD system and the iPad charger, just as fast. And then finally, for the last 6% of the iPhone 10, your regular iPhone charger will be just as fast. So you will not get any benefits from 94 to 100%. You will do just fine with the regular 5-watt chargers found in every single iPhone since the beginning of iPhones. All right, so what this tells you is pretty much that if most of the time you're looking to charge and your phone is constantly below 73%, by all means, the USB-C PD charging system with the iPhone USB-C to Lightning adapter cable is going to give you the best performance for the amount of time that you have plugged in. But if you're between the 73 to 100% mark most of the time, like you just don't use your phone as much, or you're always around that period because you never drop below 73%, you can save yourself a lot of money and just use a 10-watt USB charger that is typically found in every single iPad that has been released, and you will do just as fast. And if you're stuck with wireless fast charging, and you're usually between the 76 to 100% mark on the iPhone 10, you will be charging just as fast under optimal conditions. And that means no case and putting it right optimally right on the charging pad. Or you can wait until the Apple iPhone, the Apple Pad, whatever charger they're going to call it. I forget the name of it. But when that comes out next year, you're going to do just as fast on that. All right. Unless, for some reason, they raise it up to 15 watts, just as fast as the Qi wireless standard is capable of doing, just like Samsung did. In which case, then all of this changes. And then finally, if you're always between the 94 to 100% mark and you're just getting a little top up, the regular iPhone charger is just as fast and you don't need to spend any more money. And, you just don't need to waste any money in USB PD charging. If you don't use your phone that much and you're constantly right around the point where your phone's almost always topped up and you don't need it critically to be with you on a go for several hours at a time.